Hello, I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Barry by my students. Today I want to talk about the differences between classic and Google Cloud printers. So, let's get started.
Google Cloud Print, a complete guide. Google Cloud Print has been around since 2011, but has only been in the last few years where we have seen a larger impact of this wonderful technology. As time marches on, we have seen more and more features being added to Google Cloud Print. Let's get started with the basics and answer the question, what is Google Cloud Print? It's basically a way of for users to connect their printers, whether they be wired or wireless, to the internet and have the ability to print from any device, such as a smartphone, Chromebook, desktop PC, etc. You can also print from anywhere in the world. For example, you can print your trip pictures while you're still on your trip. What's nice about Google Cloud Print is that you can print from a device without needing to install any printer drivers on the system. This saves you an enormous amount of time and energy. So in this diagram here, we have a person here in Hawaii, and he has his Chromebook. Looks like he's doing some charts, some work there. He's connected to the internet at home. His home is connected to the internet with his printer there. And he prints right to the home. Another case here, here's someone else, a friend of his, where he's sharing his printer to. And this friend is also printing to that printer. With a classic printer, you need to connect it to your network. Then you have to find the printer drivers. Then load the software and go through all the steps to get installed on your Windows PC. Not only does this older method take a lot of your time, but you may also have to do some troubleshooting to get everything to work properly. It also slows down your system with a lot of extra printer software and tools that you don't even need. With a Google Cloud printer, you just install the Google Cloud printer driver on your Windows machine, and you can now print from any program directly to any printer you have added in Google Cloud Print. So is Google Cloud Print the greatest thing in the world? I think it's so, and here's why. Where can I print from? Google Cloud Print sounds great, but you might be asking, from where can I actually print from? Well, that's where Google Cloud Print has been making big leaps since it came out in 2011. At first, you can only print from Chrome OS, the Google Chrome browser on any PC, Mac, or Chromebook, and Gmail and Google Docs on your mobile device. Now you can print a much wider selection of items and file types, such as photos, from any of your internet-connected devices. Remember, this all works as long as you are connected to your Google account on those devices. Now, why is this so important? Because your Google Cloud printer is registered to your Google account, and only you with that account and those that you are sharing with can print to your printer. If this were not the case, then anyone would be able to print to your printer. So this is a safeguard to keep your printer private so that only you can print to it. Luckily for all of us, you can log into your Google account on any device that connects to the internet, such as an Apple iPad or Apple iPhone, Android smartphone, a tablet, a Windows PC, a Mac PC, or a Chromebook, etc. There are now many apps on the Play and web stores that allow you to print to your printer from any device as well. Here are a few examples from the for your Android device. So here we see Cloud Print to Google Cloud Print, Cloud Print Plus, Brother iPrint and Scan, Canon Print Service, Cloud Printer. So all these apps here we see are free, and they do basically the same thing. They allow you to print from any of your devices to your printer. And here we see Google Cloud Print. And it says it lets you print or send a PDF files and images to your printer to Google Cloud Print. With this app, you can make your pictures to or print your pictures at home or your office. Alrighty. This is Save to Google Cloud Print, another free app. And here's what it would look like when you have your print jobs. It comes up with the different things that you've printed and the date of when you printed the item in case you needed to print again. Here you would see your list of Google Cloud printers that you've registered to your account. These apps also allow you to connect to your Facebook and print such things as a Facebook post or anything from your Dropbox, your Google Drive, your SkyDrive, which is also called OneDrive, Microsoft's, from your mail, or even different web pages. So with these apps, users can print a variety of local files directly to Google Cloud Printer, including SMS chats, pictures, Facebook posts, Dropbox, Box, mail, and more. Users can also manage printers, share printers, manage print jobs, and more from these apps. Back in 2013, Google made Google Cloud printers a lot more useful by introducing the Google Cloud Print driver for Windows. You can install this on any Windows machine, and it will allow you to choose a Google Cloud printer when printing from any Windows application. So here I took a screenshot on my machine. I just went Control P from Microsoft Word, and when you do that shortcut of Control plus the letter P, you get your print options here, and you notice I can select a printer. So there it is. Now any of your printers that you've added would be showing up here as well. And then once you've selected the printer that you want, you click on print, and it sends that document to the printer, no matter where the printer is located. They also released Google Cloud Print Service in addition to Print Driver. Cloud Print Service runs as a Windows service and can be used to connect older legacy or classic printers to your Google Cloud Print services. Lastly, there is a list of apps that work with Google Cloud printers and allows you to print from them. For example, on iOS, you can download Print Central Pro, which will let you print emails, contacts, text messages, etc. from an Apple iOS device to your Google Cloud printer. Let's take a look at this list now. So here's the list, apps that work with Google Cloud Print. So the following applications allow you to print to Google Cloud Print. Those marked made by Google were built and maintained by Google. Alrighty. So on all devices, you can always print from your Chrome browser. community. So that would be regardless whether you have a Windows or a Mac or a Linux or an Android. If you click on this icon, anything you see in there, you can print. And we do that usually on a Windows machine. We hit the shortcut Control plus P. If you have an Android device, there's many, many options here, many apps. You just need one. Actually, you don't need any if you're using the Chrome browser, but there are many apps out there. We can see the long list here. There's Google Cloud Print here. On your Apple iOS device, we have Print Central Pro. There you go. On any mobile device, you also have mobile Google apps, the web, Kodak email print. Then if you have a Macintosh or Windows PC, you have Cloud Printer, the web, paperless printer, Cloud Print for Windows, RapWolf, Google Cloud Printer for Windows. If you're for enterprise or education versions of operating systems, you also have Google Cloud Print Connector, Uniflow, Presto, Green Tools for Google Apps, and the list goes on and on. So there's a long list here of apps that work with any of your devices to make it the printing easy for you. Now that you understand where you can currently print from, let's take a look at connecting printers to the Google Cloud Print service. So here we have a diagram here, and you can print from your tablet, your phone, your Chromebook, your PC, Mac, or Linux computer that is connected to the cloud. This means the internet. And you can print, of course, to your cloud-ready printer. That's any of the newer printers that are out that say that they are Google Cloud-ready. They will have a stamp on them that says such. B, a PC with the Chrome browser using a wired or a wireless printer. And then the last option here is a print server with a network printer. Cloud Print Ready versus classic printers. The main thing to understand about Google Cloud printers is how you connect to the printers to the local actual service. There are two types of printers in the Google world: Google Cloud Ready and classic printers. These printers may be laser or inkjet. It does not matter. Cloud Ready printers are those that are already come with the Google Cloud Printer service installed and configured, making the whole process very easy. This is by far the best way to use Google Cloud Print service, because the printer will actually register itself with the Google Cloud Printer service over your network and will always be available for printing, regardless of whether or not there are Windows PCs attached to the printer. So in this diagram, we have again your tablet, smartphone, a Chromebook or a Windows or a Mac PC connected to the internet, and you've purchased a Google Cloud Print Ready printer. And from any of those devices, no matter where you're located, you can print to your printer. The other great thing about Cloud Ready printers is that they will automatically update their firmware and drivers over the internet, so you don't even have to worry about it. Ready for more good news? There are now more of these types of printers out there that support Google Cloud Printing. Let's look at the list of printers now. Now this list is available on the internet. Just Google Cloud Ready Printers list and you'll find this list right away. And the way they divide up, because there's thousands of printers out there, the way they divide this up is by manufacturer of the printer. So it's alphabetical. We start with Brother. So these are the supported printers here. If you go to Canon, there's a long list of Canon printers. Here's Dell printers. One of my favorite printers out there is Dell. And I've had a number of Dell printers. Always been happy with those. Develop, so if you're in business here. Epson, a lot of people have Epson. They're a big name in the printer area. Long list there. HP, HP printers. Kodak. Another version of Kodak here. Konica. So we see some Konica printers in offices. I've also seen this printer in different schools and offices. Lexmark. Seen this in some offices. Here's Oki. Pentium. And remember, they have different types. So you have, here, this is a black and white, basically, just a monochrome, like laser printers. But here's multifunction printers. That's the ones that come with the scanner. Probably color. Here's another one there. Ricoh. Long list for Ricoh. Samsung. This is actually what I went with. I went with this one right here, the Express C410W. This one right there. Very happy with that color laser printer. Here's another maker of printers. And you can't leave out them. So here's the URL that I was just at. If you do have one of the printers listed here, you can use this link for setting it up and registering it with your Google Cloud account. It is easier than you think. The Google link above also has a set of instructions which allow you to easily set up and register your Google email address with the Google Cloud Print service on the printer. So if you remember back when I was at that page, if you look at the bottom, it said setup instructions. So each of the different printer types had their own instructions. Next up are classic printers. Classic printers are what a majority of people will be using when setting up Google Cloud Print service. Classic printers are either printers that are directly connected to your Windows computer via a USB cable, or wireless printers installed on your machine. Any printer that you can print to from your computer can be added to the Google Cloud Printer service, regardless of how it is connected. So here in this diagram, we see again the same assortment of devices connected to the internet. But this time we have older printers that are considered classic printers. And regardless of whether it's a wireless printer or a printer connected through a USB or a network printer, you can add these printers to your Google Cloud Print service and then print to them. Now, the major difference between a cloud-ready and a classic printer is that in order to print to any classic printers, the computer that has the printers installed has to be on, and you have to be logged into your Google account. If you turn off the computer or log out of Chrome and try to print to the Google Cloud Printing service, the print job will simply be added to the print cache where it sits. When the computer turns back on and you log into your Chrome, the print job will then be printed. Adding a classic printer. Adding a classic printer to Google Cloud Print is fairly straightforward. First, go to the computer that has the printer already installed and open the Chrome browser and log into your account. Then click on the Chrome menu button. This is usually three small dots near the top right-hand corner, and choose Settings. Let me demonstrate. So here I am in my Chrome browser now. I click on the three dots. I go down to Settings. Now once I'm in Settings, I see that I am signed in as me, so make sure that you are signed into your account before going any further. Then you click over here where it says Search Settings and simply type in Printer. And as soon as you begin typing the word print, look what it says. It says Google Cloud Print. Set up or manage printers in Google Cloud Print. And what we're going to do is we're going to click on Manage. And what happens is it shows all of your devices. Now immediately it looks for new devices, so if I have added a printer to my Windows machine, it'd be adding it right now as we speak. But look what it says. It says, looks like there are no new devices available to register on your network. So you go down and it says classic printers, my devices. And these are the printers I have registered to my account right now. So I have a Samsung C410W, and this is in the office. I have a Dell 1250C color printer, that one as well. That's in another location. We have other options, which is just always are there. Save to your Google Drive, you can always do that. You can always fax it too. You can go Microsoft Print to PDF, so that's an option. And Microsoft XPS Document Writer, that's another option. And here's one that came with my Samsung. It's called Samsung Cloud Print. That was just an app that came with the Samsung color laser printer that I use. Now, for some reason, I wanted to go into one of these and manage them. I click on Manage. And from here, we see who's the owner. So it's owned by me. I printed something just 3 days ago. I don't disclose the location, so I haven't typed that in. And notice some options here. I can delete the printer if I sold it or gave it away. I can share the printer, meaning other people can actually print to this. It doesn't have to be me in my account. It could be anyone that I share the printer with. I can show the print jobs to see exactly what was printed to my printer. So these particular projects were printed to that particular printer there. You see like the mini grant, the student verifications, and some documents there. And so this area here is very, very useful because I can also do things such as rename if I wanted to change the name of the printer so that when I do share the printer, they have a better idea of where the printer is located. I can change things like that, all in this window. From that screen, you can choose to automatically register new printers when you connect them to your computer. That's all there is to adding printers to the Google Cloud Printing Service. Now, it will take you to the Google Cloud Printer Management Console, where you should see all of your printers listed. So that's what we saw there. All of your printers, they're called devices, but we know them as printers. Uploading files to print. In addition to the various ways that you can print, mentioned just what we did, you can also have the option to upload a file directly to Google Cloud Print Service and print it. So, for example, if you're on a Mac and want to print a PDF file or an image or a Word document or whatever, you can just upload it. You would log into your GCP console and you click the print. And you can upload the file to print. So let me show you that. So again, all I did was hit Control plus B and went into my what's called print jobs. And I can go from here and do my work, whatever I wanted to do with printing. From what I can tell, it seems like you can print any kind of file. I was able to even print an Adobe Photoshop files, MS Word docs, spreadsheets, etc. So far, I haven't been able to not print something. So that's really great. Sharing printers. One neat feature of Google Cloud Print Service is the ability to share a printer with someone else that has a Google account. It's got to be one of the best features I have seen in any printer. Let me show you how to share a printer. So from this window here, I hit Control plus P. And I find the printer dialog box here, which allows me to change which printer I'm printing to and other options. But if I go to the word change right here, and then I go down to manage on where it says Google Cloud Print Manage, this opens up our console, our Google Cloud Print console. Go down here to printers. Click on the printer that you wish to share, and then click Share. So let's click on one of these and click on Share. Right now it's private. You go down here and you begin typing someone's email address. So you type a friend's email address down there and you see what privilege you want them to have. In this case, I want them to be able to print to the printer. That makes sense. Okay. So they have options there. And once I am sure I want to share that printer, I click on the word share. Now that person's email has been added to that printer. So now they have the ability to print to that printer. Now, once you've added that person's email address to the printer, they in turn will receive a little message saying that so-and-so wants to share a printer with you. They can click on accept or reject. And that is literally it. Then the person who you just shared the printer with can print to your printer as if they were connected straight to it via a USB cable. there is no need to use your computer. No need to download printer drivers on their computer. Just send a link, click on it, and print. Next time someone visits you and needs to print and you don't want them to be on your computer, use the Google Cloud Print service. It's the first time in a long time I have been impressed by something working so well and effectively. Conclusion. By using Google Cloud Print, you can consolidate all of your printers into one place. For example, if you have a wireless printer installed on one machine, but have a second printer connected by a cable to a second machine, you can add both printers to Google Cloud Print and print to either printer from any computer or any mobile device. In addition, you can print any file to your Google Drive or directly to other storage. The ability to save to Google Drive kind of makes Google Cloud Print like Evernote. You can print a web page for later viewing straight to your Google Drive. Overall, Google Cloud Print has become a lot more useful since it was introduced in 2011. Google will continue adding more features to this wonderful service, which will make it a great way for consumers to print easily from anywhere and from any device. Please like and subscribe to my Selma Teacher 7 channel. Thanks for watching and have a great day.